Well, with talks about global temperatures rising in some areas, there's a lot of discussion on ways we can adapt. And there's new research giving scientists a better idea of how trees are adapting.
Yeah, they've even been growing in places where they haven't been seen since the last ice age. KCRA3 meteorologist Heather Waldman explains how that's possible.
Earth's global average temperature is rising, but it's not rising at the same rate everywhere. Research released just this week shows that the Arctic may be warming up to 4 times faster than the rest of the planet. And that kind of warming is already yielding a shift in the ecosystem. I spoke with Dr. Roman Dial, who's a biologist at Alaska Pacific University. Dial's research focuses on white pine trees. Turns out, these trees are now growing in colonies up to 25 miles north of the established tree line.
That's a real clear case that the climate is changing, because trees are long lived and climate is something, unlike weather, that extends over a longer period of time. And these trees take 30 years to mature and produce cones. So this is a real clear signal that the climate has indeed warmed.
Dial's research is focused right here in northern Alaska, a region that can be classified as the Arctic tundra, essentially a frozen desert. Historically, this area has been too cold and too dry for trees to survive. But in recent decades, increasing air and ocean temperatures have led to warmer soils, better soil nutrients, and a bigger snowpack, which can actually shield seedlings from harsh winter winds. Dial says that these tree colony populations double and move about 2.5 miles every decade. So while the process is slow, relative to a human lifetime scale anyway, this sort of tree migration does have future climate implications. According to Dial, more trees in the Arctic would likely lead to more warming.
The soils where these trees grow, they'll warm more. And that's where most of the carbon is in the Arctic. It's in the soils. And so as those soils warm, that carbon will be released into the atmosphere. And that's even more, you know, greenhouse gases.
And Dial says that while he focuses on the northern extent of boreal forests, there is evidence to show that the southern extent of these trees is also shifting as more succumb to increased heat stress, drought, and wildfires. I'm meteorologist Heather Waldman for KCRA 3 News.